big, strong, you know, body that clears the middle of the floor. So definitely got to be a focus for Saskatchewan to keep the guys out of the middle.
Oh, there's a big shot. He had a goal last week. He's going to put another one up this week. It's Robert Church. He gets the first tally of the day for Saskatchewan.
And then to be shorthanded there. And again, yeah, like you mentioned, just kind of bobbled that. What a save by Dylan Ward.
Dylan Ward showing you the splits and keeping the big stick out there. Phenomenal save. Now on the transition, goal! Flying through is Ryan Lee. Ryan Lee does not mind Rugburn at all. That guy jumps on the carpet more than anybody I think at the league sometimes. Players, no, thought better about it. Probably the right decision there. And Robinson got caught down there on defense, so he's going to go sub off. Kinnear moving in, shot, goal, that one went in. I thought it went off the glove that time of shoot, but it found its way in, Jamie. You're going to have to explain to me how this found twine. The Mammoth have subbed out, and this will be a settled opportunity for the Rush. Yeah, again, this offense is interesting as Courier looks to maybe activate again. Takes a shot, that one goes in. That was just one of those sneaky underhanded shots. I thought he was looking to set something up. Wasn't even sure he was going to take the shot. Next thing you know, there's another goal on the board for Saskatchewan.
Yeah, we
Matthews so far, though. He has the ball right now. Now it's back. Church fire. Another save by Dylan Ward. They are definitely trying to get Ward. Go pipe to pipe. There's Courier. Shot and a goal. He was left all alone. Oh, man. Everybody just kind of lost Courier, and he did a great job of just sneaking in behind the defense. Josh Courier with number two on the afternoon. Got 23 basically.
Yeah, they're just going to play straight up here.
They'll have about a minute of power play time when this is all elapsed. Saskatchewan working around. Shot and a goal.
Cheer, and we're going to go 4-on-4 and see if they attack and put Tyler Digby in the two-man game and go after him.
Okay, he's got Jeffries following Courier. Now Matthews trying to line up. They had the pick, so Digby had to be on Matthews.
Wow.
Just a back and forth game, and there's the goal. Yes, so I'm going to let you. Interesting possession that last time for Zed Williams. Did a lot of running around, ultimately found a shot, but I know from talking to the guys, there's Mark Matthews, swim move and a goal. That's what he can do. Mark Matthews does not care about your attempt at defense. This afternoon.
Yeah, and those are the games as a goaltender you just want to kind of write off. And get back at it and rebound. And Adam Shoup's doing a great job of that where he's playing this first half.
Lachlan clearing for Robinson. Shot and a goal! Connor Robinson loves him some home cooking as he gets another goal.
And the former
stretch now looks to be the Rush. We also have the first half highlights from around the league. And we have a busy day, at least a busy weekend. I should say a busy day, but we're one of two games that wraps up the game. And we got Ryan Lee going in and a shot and a score.
Yeah, they're going to get some action there, Ryan Lee.
Was there.
Yeah, one of those. We don't see Ryan Lee make mistakes like that too often. Just one of those where, you know, you maybe hear some footsteps because you're cutting the middle. Oh, wow.
That was beautiful. That's how you draw it up. That's tic-tac-toe right there, folks.
Love his play. You know, even when he loses the draw, you know, he's just a very physical, agitating player to play against.
Eli McLaughlin looks over the situation, gets a pick now. There's a shot from Ryan Lee, and he gets it in. Right, you don't want me near your goalie? Fine, I'll shoot up top. And the little hopper skips in, and the Mammoth are within two again, 7-5. But Mammoth get the ball again, and we've got 15 seconds to go on this penalty and that much time on the shot clock. This will be shot, goal! You don't need all the time. Ryan Lee's going to get another one up top. Goal number four. Don Lintz going to hop pass it over to Zed Williams, who will set up. 17 on the shot clock, about a 16-point difference. Shot and a goal! Again! Connor Robinson. All of a sudden, the Mammoth, who seem to be doing all their work for offense inside the crease with their dives in the first half, have decided to go shoot from up top.
Well, that. And you see Eli McLaughlin is on the floor. He was the one that just set doing the work and just took two guys there to get his teammate an open shot.
Oh, and another good rebound in action, and again, the Rush takes the lead.
That's the kind of shift that the Mammoth coaching staff wants to see from their offense.
This ought to get some tempers up again. As boy,
here we go. We're gonna have a break
situation
here. Johnny Lintz.
All right, let's get this all. Johnny Lintz with the goal. Games I called more juniors. Games.
I am not going to live that down. I can tell you that. Right
now. So the Mammoth working it around. Oh, right in front is Eli McLaughlin, and with the patience, finds the right angle to put it in.
Doing work.
Colorado now, that's going to be Zed Williams trying to force the action physically there. Eli McLaughlin going down to the corner. I believe that's Connor Robinson. Now back over to Williams. Down to Ryan Lee. They'll switch places. Lee again shoots. I don't know what is going on from the top, but he's got his fifth goal of the day. We're one away from the footwear getting thrown on the floor again.
Yeah, that's the kind of shift that the Mammoth coaching staff wants to see from their offense.
This ought to get some tempers up again as, boy.
Here we go. We're going to have a break
situation.
Here. Johnny Lintz. You know, far, near, far he went there. And, yeah, Dylan Ward gave him no room there. And I think it hit the pipe. Ah.
But that one will get through for the Rush as they climb one goal closer. Again, not going to go away. And that's going to be Currier, who has a hat trick on his day. They've got to play some good defense. There's a shot. Goes over the goal. Mammoth can't corral the ball. Loose ball's up for grabs. It is eventually taken. There's the empty netter. We'll see if that seals the deal. Warren Jeffrey able to get out there from his defensive position. One was popped out that time by Turner. Is he able to get it up?
And see, this is always a debate with faceoffs. And are they important? Do they help you win games? And look at this.
Messenger doesn't want to hear your criticisms of faceoff wins.
I was just going to say.
Playing a little Fogo. Take it and go. Why not Mike Messenger? Oh, and there's another loose ball. Can they get out there? Kinnear's got to get it. No call. The player went down. Kinnear, open net. Boom. And it's now 12-10. 18 seconds left. I'm sorry. It was Gillies. Gillies broke out and on the run added the empty netter.